I don't think George is referring to a new type of timepiece.
No, David.
When I speak of time, gentlemen, I'm referring to the fourth dimension.
Go on, George.
Well, the difficulty in explaining the fourth dimension is that it cannot be seen or felt.
If you don't mind, George, would you refresh me on the first three dimensions?
Oh, really, Philby? Surely they taught you something in school?
Suppose you explain it, Doctor.
Huh? Oh, certainly. Well, for example, when I move in a straight line, forward or backward, that's one dimension. And when I move to the left or right, two dimensions. And when I move up or down, three dimensions. For instance, that box. Well, that box has three dimensions, length, breadth, and height.
Yes, but what is the fourth dimension?
Oh, well, that's it. Oh, that's mere theory. No one really knows what the fourth dimension is, or even that it exists.
On the contrary, Doctor. The fourth dimension is as real and true a dimension as any of the other three. In fact, they couldn't exist without it.
What do you mean?
Well, let's take that box. It has the first three dimensions, as you said.
Oh, all right, but what's in that box?
I'm coming to that. Let's consider this first. Why is it that we usually ignore the fourth dimension? Because we have no freedom of movement within it. You see, we can move in the other three. Up, down, forward, sideways, backward, as the doctor said. But when it comes to time, we are prisoners. Do you follow me, Bridie?
No. George, you've given a most lucid explanation and all that, but I'm afraid I don't quite understand.
Walter, look, there are many things in this world you don't understand, aren't there?
Yes, quite a number.
Well, you don't refuse to believe in them because of that, do you?
No, not if I can see the proof with my own eyes.
Good, Walter. Gentlemen, all I'm asking you to do now is to witness a demonstration of the possibility of movement within the fourth dimension.